Hello, YouTube. That's right. I'm responding to myself. I'm sure that means I have some kind of mental problem. I wanted to go ahead and submit an entry for myself to the Under 100 Club. Now, when I started the Under 100 Club, I was under 100 subscribers. Well, right now, I have exactly 100 subscribers. But I kind of consider it to be sitting on a line, because one of those subscribers is an account that I know for a fact should have been deleted weeks ago. So, honestly, if you're watching this, you probably already know a little bit of who I am. I'm a 26-year-old college student from Arkansas. I'm a big comic book geek. I'm a computer science student. I'm studying computer science. I write parking tickets to, you know, pay my rent and bills and whatnot while I'm in school. I love cheesy movies. I'm a big Mystery Science Theater fan. In fact, you're gonna love this. See, I went to the Best Buy and I finally got myself a copy of Volume 10 of the Mystery Science Theater Collection. Look at that. $45. That's before tax. Four good movies. I'm getting ready to watch one of them tonight, I hope. Anyway. So, yeah, essentially, that's me. But what I really wanted to do, what I really, really wanted to do was to introduce you all to some of my subscribers that I think really stand out. Now, that's not to say that any of my other subscribers aren't worth watching and don't have good videos. Just that the ones I'm going to mention, I don't know, they have that unspeakable something. You know, the whatever it is that makes for good videos. Or at least in my opinion. So, let's take a look. Okay, so I'm doing this through a mirror right now because, I can't find an angle that you can see my computer monitor so I can show you basically these people the way I want to, and you still be able to see me. So, there you have it. So, here we go. Now, mind you, all of these people I'm going to show you have under 100 subscribers, and all of them are worth watching. First off, Rocket Number 09. He hasn't done anything in a while. In fact, the last time he did a video was 1 month ago. Basically, most of what he does is movie reviews. They're really entertaining, and he's really good at them, I think. He was actually my first subscriber, and I believe I was his. Yes, I was. So, definitely check him out. Now, hopefully, if you know more of you start watching, he'll make more. Kazzy Rose. Some pretty good music videos set to a number of different movies. Also, in response to a couple of my videos, she's done some videos with Flopsy the Bunny, which was really funny. And she's done a couple of videos on her own that just, you know, have the bear here, which... that's one badass bear, I'll just tell you. Really worth watching yet again. Court Nugent. I don't know. She seems to think that her videos are boring. She mentions it at least once every other video. They're not that boring, actually. I find them quite humorous and entertaining. Check her out. Cop Kitty, I believe, has the stuff to be the next big YouTube celebrity. She's got a particular style. She does a lot of videos that are responses to other people's videos. But, you know, honestly, she could do videos on her own and get just as many hits, I think. She has excellent taste in music as well. I'd give her a look, please. One Tin Soldier. Found One Tin Soldier because... Actually, he found me. Because we both currently reside in Fayetteville, Arkansas. A lot of what he does is music videos. Well, not music videos, more as recordings... live recordings of bands that play here in town. And other places. On top of that, he's also got some nice social commentary videos, a couple of them in response to Renetto and such. Again, worth checking out. James Mowry. James Mowry is, well, not so much new to YouTube, but newer to making videos, only about a month or so ago, I believe. But he's really coming along quite well. If we can get him to make more videos more often, it'd be great. He's really playing around with video editing and doing these little intros to his videos that they're really entertaining. He also does music of his own, which he usually has in the background of his videos. So give James a look. I'm not even sure how to pronounce it. It's like four P's and then the word panic. So is it panic? I don't know. I've only seen a couple of her videos so far, but what I've seen, I've really enjoyed. There was the, what was it? Something with a banana song? When YouTubers collide, I thought that was just, that was really entertaining. I like that. So, give her a look. Duck Manchu. I've mentioned this before. This is actually a friend of mine in real life. He's only got four videos. Basically, he basically takes movies and kind of chops them up, changes the sounds, changes the editing a little bit. Some of them are music videos, some of them are just, they're all very funny. Check them out, please. And a recent subscriber to me, I'm going to try and pronounce this right, Sonolamia Kenzone. Is that one word or supposed to be two? I'm not sure. Anyway, she makes a lot of these karaoke videos that are really fun. I really kind of ran into her videos watching responses to Blunty 3000, where she was basically a transgender Blunty. Really funny. Check her out. So that's really all I can think of for right now. Again, just because I didn't mention somebody doesn't mean their videos aren't worth watching. In fact, a lot of people are out there that I probably don't even know about yet. One of the reasons why I created the Under 100 Club. Basically, they really deserve more views than they're getting, more subscriptions than they're getting. So that's why the Under 100 Club is here. Hopefully some of the people I mentioned who haven't already will post responses to the Under 100 Club and introduce us to themselves and maybe some other people that they enjoy watching. So, until next time, bye.